Alright guys, welcome back to the Gothic Build, and we are on 1.3, which means I can do this, which makes me happy. Unfortunately, I can't use single player commands, which makes me very upset, but I guess we're going to have to get over it. It's not fair! Right, so what we're going to do is, I'm going to work out how to make this look right, which will probably involve some upside down slabs and some stone stairs, and this is going to be the beginning of kind of one of the themes that's going to run throughout the build. So let me just rearrange some stuff while a car drives past. Okay, so one of the themes that's going to go throughout the build is going to be these kind of overhanging, I don't really know what to call them. You know, at the top of like a tower or a wall where it kind of sticks out at the top, mainly on the castle. It's got that kind of bit that sticks out because it's something that I've wanted to use for a while but haven't really managed to get right. So, this is a bit of experimentation. I haven't tried this before. But I think this with either iron railings or wooden fence, probably wooden fence on top, could look quite nice. This is going to be the small version, so there'll be a small version which will look like this, and then a thicker version which I will work out later, but it'll probably look something along those lines. Maybe that'll be reduced like that. I don't know. We'll work that out when we get there. Let's do this one step at a time, so I think get overwhelmed. Decoration, please. Thank you. Okay, so let's. Oh man, there is no cars going outside my house, so I thought, I know, I'll leave my window open. Big freaking mistake! Can we have these sticking out? I think that looks quite nice. I like that. We can stay with that. There you go. That way it looks like the wood's kind of coming along here. In fact, we could even do that. It would just make the cobblestone bit a lot more interesting, and I might try something else now. Okay, right, okay, let's give it a go. 5-4-2-1. Oh, I don't have single player commands. Shit! Give Jamziboy 4-3-1. Oh, don't throw it! Oh, you fucking troll. Right, now if I put these down there, it looks alright actually from underneath. I quite like that, and I definitely like it from up here. Yeah, let's do that. Just making these walls a little bit more interesting, because when I first started doing this world editing on this on this bit here, it was so daunting. Like everything was just kind of staring me like, look, I'm a massive wall of cobblestone, do something with me, which is horrible. Right, so that's quite a nice little bit. I'm gonna change these to be the stone. What if I did that? Or would that make it too flat? Makes it a little bit too flat. What if I went like that? No, I think I preferred the wood sticking out. The wood's good. Wood can stay. So let's just pop this on here. Why am I doing this at night? I don't have single player commands! Ah, fix it! Jesus Christ. Ah, this is going to annoy me. Ooh, I've got a text. Nope, don't answer it now. Right. So let's go and do this inside piece here. And we will go in. Oh, well, we'll do a 3x3, I guess. That makes sense, doesn't it? Stop driving past my house! It's like I live in the middle of nowhere, which means I get shit internet. And that is made up for by the fact that there's nobody around, except there are people fucking around! So there's no fucking benefit for living here. Except there's no chavs. I don't actually know what the kind of pseudonym for chav is in America. I thought it was trailer trash, but they're not really the same thing. I don't know. I mean, even in different parts of the UK, the word chav means different things. It's just scummy cunts. That's the best word. But then I know some people who are quite normal who describe themselves as chavs, and I'm like, what? Why would you want to associate yourself with that? I don't freaking know. Psychology is a big subject, and it doesn't make much bloody sense. Right, let's now. That's okay. We can live with that. 1, 2, 3. We will stick one here as well. There we go. Now I'm going to remove this as well. Oh, world editor, please. Oh, I'm just going to have to come along at the end and fix everything that I fucked up. Alright, so these are going to be archways going on the underside. Not like that. There'll be archways on the other side. I'm going to go in and make enclaves as well. I'll have a walkway as well. So I need to go back further. Not much further though. I think just 2-block walkway would be fine. I'm also going to need to use some more interesting materials because this is going to look very cobbly if I don't watch it. I'll add some wooden beams in and stuff like that, wooden supports. But anyway, let's remove all of this. Go right back and... Typical, I removed the one block I didn't want to. Frickin' spam clicking, man, I want worded it. You can be my personal army in this. No, not personal army. You can be my spies, let's say. When you see single player commands has been updated, spam the shit out of me. Actually, no, don't. I'll regret saying that, won't I? Yeah, I'll definitely regret saying that. Don't spam the shit out of me. I will. Yes, I really want it. I think what's probably happened is the guy did what I did last month, where I just didn't upload anything. He's just been like, shit, I don't want to. Just leave me alone. If I bury my head, it'll all go away. Which is exactly what I did. Except I didn't want anything to go away. I just kind of let it. It was really dumb. Still, I feel a lot better coming back. So to take, you know, spend a lot more time on things. I've even been thinking about doing a splash screen in my videos with links to other videos. I don't know if there's an easy way of doing that, but by kind of looking around, it seems that the only way to do that is to spend frickin' ages on your editing software faffing around, you know, but like inserting in the videos and then making them smaller and cutting them to the right bit and then sticking the annotations on. I really wish there was an easy way of doing that. The thing is, I delete my videos after I upload them because I don't have enough hard drive space to keep them all, which is a pain in the ass. Yeah, what can I do? What can I do? Right, so we got a thing, and this is going to be a wooden walkway. Oh dear! Oh fucking brilliant! Right, this is going to be a pain in the ass. Let me get rid of this first, and I'll get rid of only one layer at first so that I don't have to faff around with fixing the water, which means I won't have to go on to 1.2.5 to actually fix the water, which is good. So I'll do that, then I'll remove the fly, there we go, then remove that. Let me take our bucket of water and spam the shit out of everything and hope that it all fixes itself. Which it has almost done. There we go. Come on. Almost there. Is that everything? Yes, it is. Right, now we need to remove. I think we'll go 1 block lower. There we go. These, the gaps in between the, like these pillars, they seem very thin. I'm a bit worried about how that will actually look, but we'll have a look in a minute. We'll see. I'm worried that they're going to look far too thin and it's going to look like the whole thing couldn't actually hold itself up, but it might be alright. We shall see. It does look a little thin. I think it's alright though. That's okay. Yeah, that's cool. That's fine. Yeah, that's fine. Right, so we need wood kind of, that looks weird, doesn't it? Right, let's put our 43, typical, I got rid of the 43, why do I always do that? Use Jamziboy, 43, 1. When I need to keep a block in my inventory, and then I need to, you know, I need to get another block out, I always delete the block that I needed to keep. Every time. It's like my brain just scans over it and it's just like there is something to do with keeping that block. Oops. We should just totally get rid of it. That would be the best thing to do. Right, so there's a nice little lip going along there. That's like a little bit weird. I'm gonna just add this in here, just for a little bit of, you know, just for a bit of a change. This probably doesn't matter because it's quite far underwater. I don't think I need to really edit that. There we go. That's looking nice. Yeah, we should probably put some along here as well. Now the way to get up to the next section will, I don't know. I don't know how we're going to get up to the next section. We'll worry about that later. Cross off there as well. Oh, come on. There we go. There'll either be stairs there or in one of these alcoves there'll be stairs. Let's actually just see if we have a symmetrical amount. Three on each side. Yeah, so this would be the center one. I will just mark that with a little doorway there for reference. Right, so let's move up to the next layer. Like this. These definitely want to have big spaces between them. Unfortunately, we've got a problem here, but it's not too much of a big deal. Yeah, it's fine. And then we're going to want, and this is where the big kind of square is going to go, which obviously I'm going to have to start off with world a little bit. It won't actually be too big. I'm not sure. These docks are looking a little bit bigger than I was expecting them to. In fact, they're looking a lot bigger than I was expecting them to. Considering moving all this a block outwards, or maybe two. Yeah, what I'm thinking about doing is moving this two blocks out, so it'll come to one, two, it'll come to there, which will make this a nice three block wide gap, which is a lot better. And also shrinking it in one direction. I will probably remove at least this end one here, and then make the square come out about here-ish. And then just cut off the end or make it into whatever. Because we actually need to start our castle, and our castle is going to go on this piece right here-ish. So thereabouts. Now, I was a bit worried that I'd run out of space, but I actually think that we're going to be okay for space. I'm going to cover this in houses, so it should be okay. It's definitely going to be a lot smaller than the picture, but it's not necessarily a terrible thing, because if a series goes on forever, people get bored. Especially because considering I'm not doing the kind of build that I did, on the Wailing Town, where I'd build it and then I'd do a time lapse and then show you around. Because you guys really didn't like that, which I was surprised that you didn't like it, because I thought that would be a lot more appealing to watch than me waffling on. But if you guys want it, you got it. Not a problem. This is a lot less effort. Right. Let's just do these. Oh, I never said I'm going to move them, aren't I? Oh no, but I'm moving them in world edit, so it's okay to do them now. I can just, it's not too much of a problem to move them. I had another question. Will the new version of world edit work with the in-game typey thing? It was obviously single player commands is useful for other stuff than just world edit, but if I could have world edit, that would be great. So let me know. Does world edit now work on single player without single player commands? Let me know below, because that would make life a lot easier. Also, if anyone does have world edit, could you tell me if the upside down blocks are fixed? Before, if I'd have copied this block and moved it to say here, it would go like that. Don't know why, it just would on the old world edit, and certainly on the one that's still on servers that's the same, but on single player maybe it is fixed. So let me know, because as soon as that is fixed, the Wailing Town will be up for download. So I know a lot of people have been asking about the Wailing Town, and that will be up for download. It's still on my mind. I will be doing it. Anyway, if it's not fixed, then I'm probably just going to release the Wailing Town download, and then I'll just include the texture pack that you need to have on in the download file, because obviously you'll have to use the previous texture pack because the new one won't work. Anyway, I've been talking for a while, so I guess I'll finish up here. Let me know what you think of my plan to shrink this down. I think it should be smaller. just judging by the size of the actual space that we've got to build in, having a massive docks is going to be a big problem, considering the size of some of the houses that we're going to be filling in. I mean, if we're going to have a nice big house, it's actually going to take up most of this space. So maybe that's an argument to have a bigger dock.
Don't know.
You tell me. So yeah, let me know below. Don't forget to check out my second channel for other cool stuff like PlanetMinecraft 2 and Battlefield and stuff. And I will see you guys next.